morning all. I'm Suresh, lecturer in Computer Engineering, Government Polytechnic, Masurtank. In the today's class, I will discuss what is this Android activating component, which is intent. Okay. So in the previous class, I have already discussed what is activity lifecycle, how one, if we are dealing with one activity, so it will call any number of methods. Okay, so total 7 methods are called. So from activity starting to finishing, it will flow through a group of callback functions. We discussed all those callback functions in the previous class, like onCreate, onStart, onResume. These 3 methods are called whenever that activity is showing. When activity loses the focus, then onPass and onStop will be called. And again, if the activity gains the focus, then onRestart, onStart, onResume will be called. But when activity is completely removed, then it will call this onPass, onStop, and onRestart. So that is the life cycle of an Android. And in the today's class, I will discuss one of the important component, which is called intent. Okay. So before discussing that intent, so let us consider this one. Okay. So I think these are all, you know, whenever I create a Android project, I have this source files, source folder, which will contain this .java files, and resource folder, which will contain all the images. If I want to place images in my app, then if I want to place some static files or XML files, these will be there in the layout folder. Okay. If you know about layout folder, this layout folder contains this .xml files and data files, and Excel sheets or SQL files, anything I can place in the resources. And this is also one of the important file folder, that is your manifest folder, which will contain this Android manifest.xml file, which gives the complete information about your Android application. And the project structure will be like this, build, okay, whenever you discuss about ARP file, which is acting as an interface between your .java file and the resources. For every resource that I am using, like it may be XML file, it may be image, it may be MP3 file, it may be video file, it may be data file, it may be database file. For every resource, one ID is created. One ID, that is nothing but one number. Okay, that ID identification number will be allotted in the r.java file. Okay, so this is about r.java, and these are view we will discuss at the time of UI elements. So now in the today's class, I will discuss what is this intent. Okay, so whenever you want to move from one activity to another activity, we use intents. Okay, in order to move from one activity to another activity, we use intents. Actually, we have total 4 important components of Android that I already discussed in the previous class. What are those 4 important components? Okay, so what are the 4 important components that we have discussed? Is one is your activity. Okay, and the second one is your services, and one more thing is your content providers, and the last one is broadcast receivers. So this I have given a brief introduction. Activity is nothing but whatever the single screen that you are seeing, right? That is your activity. Services are nothing but these are the background processes that will be running, okay, at the background, but these will do some specific task. Content providers are used to provide that content or data for one application, okay, by the another application. One application wants to provide the data to another application, then that is provided by using this content providers. Broadcast receivers are used to give some system announcements, or if our application wants to communicate with our Android OS, then that is possible through this broadcast receivers. So except these content providers, if I want to operate or if I want to activate these 3 components, okay, whenever I want to activate these 3 components, that is possible through one important component called intent. Okay, so intent is nothing but which is having some intention. Okay, so which is used to which is acting as a asynchronous message, which is used to communicate. If I want to make one activity to start another activity, that is possible through this intents. If I want to start the service, that is also possible through intents. If I want to give the system announcement by using this broadcast receiver, that is also possible through these intents. So we have this four important components. Out of these four important components, these activities or services or broadcast receivers, if I want to make them to work or make them to do some operation, I will do that by using this intent. Okay, we will see in detail. So I will go to this one. Yeah. So to move from one activity to another activity. So we have one activity. So we will see with examples. That is, this is very important, right? Whenever I am creating the app, compulsory from one activity, if I click on something, then I have to get the another activity. If I take like, if I open this application, okay? So if I open, for example, if I open Gmail application, okay? This is your, I think this is having Gmail or not. So it is not having Gmail. Okay, anyway, email, I will open email. So this is your first screen, right? So this is your first screen. So this is your activity. This activity contains one mail icon and this account setup. And you can set up email for most accounts in just once. You can write some mail. Okay. You can write some mail. And you can write some password. And after writing this password, you just click on next. When I click on next, some okay, username, something, it is doing some operation, but otherwise I will open one more. For example, if I open this messaging, okay, if I open this messaging, this is one activity. And whenever I click on settings, then it will open the settings, okay, settings activity. If I click on back, then again it will come. If I click on this compose, so this is one image button actually. So when I click on this one, automatically we are getting a new activity with some message. And when I click on this attachments, again some message is coming. Okay. So all these actually it is not it is a notification. Okay. So whenever one activity, whenever I am creating a Android application, I can have multiple activities. If I click on within the activity, if I click on one activity, then another activity will also be coming. So for getting that type of thing, so like we have one activity, I have a button. When I click on this button, second activity is open. Okay, second activity is open. So if I want to do this one, that is possible through intents. Okay, so for this one, we have this logic. Okay, like when I click on this button, so first of all, whatever the buttons that are created in the layout file, that is .xml file, that is your Android manifest .xml file, okay? Activity underscore main .xml file, this is your activity, okay? Underscore, so for every activity, we have two important files. One is your .xml file and .java file, that is activity main.java file. Okay, so whatever you defined, whatever the buttons or text boxes or anything that you created on this XML file, that should be linked, or that should be linked to this Java file by using this r.java file. So for every resource, or for every UI control, or for every XML file, for every image, whatever you created in the resource folder, for every resource, it will automatically create one ID. So this is r.id.button. Okay. So for this button action, some ID will be there. So by using this one, I can identify. And after that, I will use this logic. If whenever I want to handle this button click events, then I will use this button.setOnClickListener, new view.onClickListener, and whatever the logic that is there, that I will return inside this click key, on click event. Or otherwise I can do one more procedure, like for the button I will use this on click method, on click attribute or on click event, And after that, I will write for the whatever the method that I allotted for this unclick event that I will return. Okay, that is also we discussed. So, but most commonly we will use this logic for handling the buttons. So, how what is the logic behind that one is we have one activity, and within the activity, if I have a button, so when I click on this button, automatically one listener interface, that is your unclick listener. Okay, when user clicks on this button, then unclick listener will be listening that event. Once that is listening to that event, that will have its own handler. So one of the handler of this unclick listener is your unclick method. So that's why I am writing in the unclick. So first, whenever this button is there, that set unclick listener, this is listening that event, and whatever the logic related to that handling the button, if I do the button handling, whatever the logic related to handling that button, that I will return in the unclick method, which is the handler method. Okay. So first we will find the button control using find view by ID, and after the listen to the button click using this set unclick listener method, and write the button intent code by using this unclick method. Okay. So intents are nothing but basically any communication that we do with Android system is handled with the help of intents. So one activity wants to communicate with another activity. That is also possible through intents. Or whenever our application wants to communicate with the service, then that is also possible through intents. Means it makes the service to run, or it makes the service to turn off. Okay, that is also possible through intents. Or if I want to give some announcement like battery is low, then that is I have to activate this broadcast receiver. That is also possible through intents only. What are the different things is, if one activity wants to call or communicate with another activity, that is also possible through intents only. Okay, or one activity wants to send the information to another activity, that is also possible through intents only. And whenever I want to play the background music, okay, play the music at the background, some service is there. So if I want to activate the service, I use this intents only. There are two types of intents. One is your explicit intent, another is your implicit intents. Okay, so we will see that in detail. Okay, so now I will go to this important component, that is your Android activating component, which is a intent. Okay, so three of the four Android components we have already discussed. The four important components of Android are activities, services, broadcast receivers, and content providers. But except this content providers, because content providers are not activated by intents. Okay, only these content providers are not activated by intents. But if I want to activate any of the Android component, like if I want to activate the activity to open another activity, or if I want to start the service, or if I want to make the system to announce this broadcast messages, okay, all these are activated by an asynchronous message called intent. Okay, intent binds individual components to each other at runtime. You can think of intent as a messenger that requests, okay, it is like a messenger which requests an action from the components. It makes the activity to open another activity, or it makes the service, it acts as a messenger which sends a message to the service that you just start the service, or you just start the service, or it also makes the broadcast receiver, okay, it communicates with the broadcast receiver to give some announcement whether the battery is low, or whether some charging is happening, okay, charger is connected, or some other announcement. Okay, if that's announcement, if I want to give, I use of this intent object. Okay, we will see in detail. So components, whether the component belongs to your app or another, whether your application is belonging to your application, or if I want to activate the activity from your application to within the same application, one activity can start another activity. That is also possible through intents. Or from one activity, if I want to open another activity in the another application also, that is also possible through intents only. Okay, intent is created by using the intent object. Okay, for creating this intents, I have to create this intent object which defines a message to activate either a specific component, explicit intent, or a specific type of component. We will see in detail, okay, what is this explicit intent and implicit intent. For activities and services, intent defines the action to perform. Okay, so for activities and services, intent defines the action to perform. For example, to view or something. Okay, for activity, what is the intent will do is, I want to view another activity, that is thing. Services means I will send something, okay, and may specify the URI of data to act on. Okay, it may also send the URI, that is uniform resource identifier, for the data to act on, among other strings that the component being started might need to know. This is for the activities and services. Okay, we will see in detail. And for the broadcast receiver, the intent simply defines the announcement being broadcast. For example, a broadcast to indicate that device battery is low includes only known action string that indicates battery is low. Okay, this is about this one. There are separate methods for activating each of the component. Okay, so if I want to start the activity or give it something new to do by passing an intent object. Okay, this is your intent object. Okay, so for this start activity, if I want to make the activity to start another activity, then I have to use this start activity method, and for this start activity I will send this intent object as a parameter. If I want to start the service, then I have to use this start service method, and for this start service method I will send this intent object. Okay, if I take for example, so how I can do that one is simple thing is, just first what I will do is, if I want to make the activity to start another activity, so we have like activity 1, okay, activity 1.java file is there, and we have activity 2.java file. So for example, simple terms, we have two activities. So this is your activity 1.java file, and this is your activity 2.java file. Okay, this is your activity 1.java, okay, and this is your activity 2.java file. So if I want to start this activity, whenever I click on the activity, some button or anything, so it has to start this activity 2. So for this one, what is the logic over here is just very simple. First, I will create the intent object. So that is nothing but intent I equal to, how I created this intent object, just new intent. Okay, so if you know about Java, then it is simple to create an intent object. That is intent I equal to new intent. So this will create an intent object. Now if I want to start activity, okay, so what is the method that I have to use? So what is the method I have to use? This start activity message. Okay, start activity. So I have to start the activity. So start activity is the method. Okay, so I have to start the activity. For this start activity, I will send this intent as a parameter. Okay, so start activity of I. So in this, I have to mention intent I. Okay, so intent I equal to new intent. If I want to from activity 1, so that is activity 1. So this is your activity 1 dot this comma activity 2 dot class. So this is this one. Okay, this is the logic for this one. Okay, so intent I will create the object intent I, new intent. It will take two parameters, from which activity I want to go to another activity. So the first one is your the first activity. So this is your current activity. From this activity, I want to go to this activity 2. So once this is done, then I will just start the activity. If I want to start the service, then I will use start service method. Okay, so start service. So for this start service also, I will send this intent object. Okay, so here you may have another logic related to service. Okay, but the method that is used to start the service, but whenever I want to start one activity by another activity, then I will send this intent object as a parameter to this start activity method. Whenever I want to start the service, then for this start service method, I will send this intent object as a parameter. If I want to initiate this broadcast, then I will use this send broadcast message, or send ordered broadcast, or send a sticky broadcast. Okay, all these things. Okay, You can start a service by pressing passing an intent object to start service method. You can bind to the service by passing an intent to the bind service method. Or you can initiate broadcast. If I want to make the broadcast receiver to give some announcement, then for the send broadcast method, I will send this intent object as a parameter. Okay, all these things. Okay, so just these three are the important methods. We most commonly we will use these three methods. What are those? Is start activity for starting the activity. For this start activity, we will send this intent object as a parameter. If I want to start the service, then we will use this start service method for which this intent object will be sending as a parameter. If I want to give some announcement, then I will use this send broadcast method for which this intent object will be sending as a parameter. So as an intent is an object used to request an action from another component. Okay. So intent is nothing but it is an object I will create by using intent is the class. So for how I will create object for the intent, just intent I equal to or intent any name equal to new intent. So it is just a object used to request an action from other components. What are those components? It may be activity, it may be service, it may be broadcast receiver. It is used to request functionalities from other Android components. So what is the meaning of intent is, which is acting as a messenger, which will makes the activity to start another activity, or which makes the service to start its service, or which makes the broadcast receiver to give some announcement. Okay. In short, the word intent is nothing but it has some intention to do something. Okay. Which activates the other component. That's the intention of this intent. We can do many things by using intent, like navigate from one activity to another activity, or take picture from camera app, or web search, search location on map, and much more. This allows developers to easily remix different apps. Okay. So from one app, I can interact with another app also. That is also possible. So Android intents are mainly used to start the service. If I want to start the service, then I will use start service method. I can launch one activity from another activity, or even if I want to launch the activity itself also, I will use intent only. If you observe this Android manifest.xml file, if I open this Android manifest.xml file, okay. So if you see here, if I want to start the launcher also, I am using what? Intent only. These are some predefined, okay, predefined. We have this Android.intent, and what is the category of this one? Launcher. So that intent will be launcher. Okay, this is intent filter, and Android.action.main. This is the main component. Okay, so even if I want to launch the icon, launch an activity also, I require this and intent. If I want to start the service also, I require this intent. And if I want to display the web page, then also I require this intent. So for displaying the web page, what is the URL? If I want to open google.com, then I will use this intent I equal to new intent and intent.actionView, and it will set the data and so that I can start the activity. Okay. So this is for displaying the web page. And if I want to display a list of contacts, okay. So if I want to display the contacts, whatever the list of contacts are there. So for this one, I have to create the activity only. And if I want to send the broadcast message, for that also I require this intent. If I want to dial a phone call, for that also intent is required. Camera intent. Okay, if I want to open the camera application to take some picture, so for this one also intent is required. Google Maps intent. Okay, we will see in detail. And there are two types of intents are there. We have one is explicit intent, another is implicit intent. Okay, we will see in detail, and after that I will go to the example program using both. That is, if time permits, I will explain both implicit intents and explicit intents. Otherwise, I will show only one intent. Okay, in the next class I will show the another type of intent. So first one is your explicit intent. In explicit intents, target component name is directly passed in the intent at the time of creating it. Okay, so this is very important. So within the same application, that is very important. When you deal with this explicit intent, so that is nothing but within the same application. So this is nothing but within the same application. in the same application. So when within the same application, if one activity wants to start the another activity, or within the same application I want to start the service, or within the same application I want to give some announcement, then I will use this explicit intent. So because if I am within the same application, if I want to start one activity to another activity, then I know the another activity name, right? So that's why I can easily mention that name. So explicit intent is used very commonly when an activity calls another activity. For example, we have two activities. One is your login activity. This is your login activity, and this is your homepage activity. So whenever login activity means we have this username and email, and once you type this one and you just click on this login, automatically another activity will be open. So this is your login activity and homepage activity. After login app takes user to homepage, see the photo given below. This is your explicit intent. Okay, within the same application, if I want to go from one activity to another activity. So what is the logic over here is, first I will create intent object by using intent is a class and object equal to new intent. It will have two parameters. One is the first activity name and the second one is which activity I want to go. Okay, and I will use this start activity method. Okay, start activity, and for the start activity I will send this intent object as a parameter. Okay, I will send this intent object as a parameter. So what is this one? Explicit intent helps us to move from one activity to another activity. This is your activity A and this is your activity B. If I want to go from this activity to another activity, then intent I equal to new intent, activity A dot this, this is the current activity. From this activity, I want to go to this activity B. Okay, that's it. And I will start the activity. This is your explicit intent. Okay, within the same application, if one activity wants to go to another activity, that is possible through this explicit intent. But implicit intent, in implicit intents, target component name is not passed in the intent at the time of creating it. Okay, we don't have, and this is from one application to another application. Okay, implicit. So the name implicit is within like that, but it is exactly opposite. Implicit is nothing but from our application to other. Okay, so then we can say it is a implicit intent. Okay, within the same application, from one activity to another activity, or within the same application if I want to start the service, or for the same application I want to send the broadcast announcement, then that is your explicit intent. But implicit intent is nothing but from my application I want to start the activity of other application. Means from my like this, if for example if I take this one, this is actually a phone dialer application. Okay, from this phone dialer application I want to open this contacts, but contacts is different application, right? So if I open if I open this dial, okay, this is your contacts application. Okay, if I open this contacts, as we don't have any contacts, I can create a new contact. Actually if you see here, this is your contacts application. So whenever I click on this contacts application, you will get this screen. Okay, this is your main activity. So when I click on this, is a buttons, three buttons are there, and this has one message, new contacts, and it is tab. Okay, so it is like three tabs are there. This is groups related, this is your contacts, and this is your favorites. And when click on this create new contact, automatically you will get this kind of one, and you can have this kind of notification. Okay, these are dialog boxes. Okay, and click on add contact. Then when I click on this add contact, then you will get kind of another application. This is mail application, email application actually. So email application is opening. Okay, so from my application I am opening email application. Okay, so like this one. Okay, this is nothing but that is your implicit intent. From my application if I want to open other application. Okay, and in the gallery, from gallery sometimes I may have this camera picture. So if I click on this camera picture, you can see here So this is example it is showing. I can click on this front camera, back camera. Okay. So just if I click on this one, okay, you can take the picture. So if I click on this thing, then this camera is a different application, right? So if I click on this, so the camera is talking. It took the picture. Okay. So actually I am opening this gallery, but within this gallery I am taking this capture picture. So when I click on this picture, this camera application is opening. Even if I click on this camera, so it is the same thing, right? So that is your implicit intent. From this gallery app, this is one app. From this app, if I click on this capture picture, then it is opening that camera app. Okay. So that is your implicit intent. Okay. From my application, if I want to open other application activity, then I don't know what is the name of that activity, right? So for this one, we by default, we whenever creation of that activity itself, some properties will be defined, like android.content.intent, something like this. Okay, so Android decides itself which component of which application should receive this intent. Implicit intents are used to activate components in other applications. From my application, if I want to activate the other component, like it may be activity. From my application, I can start another application activity, or from my application, I can start the service of other application, or from my application, I can give the announcement, broadcast, receive, or announcement to other application. If I want to do all those things, then I will use this implicit intent. For example, if your application needs to open contacts in your phone, this intent needs another application which is contacts in phone. So the code will be looking like this. From my application, I want to open the contacts. Okay. So this is your dial pad, but from dial pad, I am opening this contacts so that it will open the contacts application. So this is your intent, and intent.setAction, this is nothing but content.intent.actionView, and it will set this data to this one by using this contacts contact.contacts.intent.contentURI, so that it will open the contacts application. So what are the methods, very important methods of intent? There are separate mechanisms for delivering intents to activities, services, and broadcast receivers. Here is the expression of few methods. So what are the three important methods? There is your start activity, which is used to start the activity. Intent is passed as a parameter to this start activity method. And start service, this method is used to launch a new service. Intent object is passed as a parameter to this start service method. And send broadcast, these are the three important methods. If I want to make the activity to start, then I will use start activity with intent object as a parameter. If I want to start the service, then start service with intent object as a parameter. Send broadcast, this method is used to send a message, okay, broadcast message to using this broadcast receiver. Intent object is passed as a parameter. So there are two primary components of intent objects. That is your action. Okay. So most of the intent objects will have this action. Okay. So action, it shows the action to be performed. This is compulsory part of intent object. Okay. The action can be either action view or action edit, etc. And it shows the data to be operator. It can be simple data type or URI. Okay. So these are the two important components that are used. Okay. So most commonly we will use this action view. And the next one is your URI. Okay. So for this one, you will send this URI. So we will see, first we will see the examples on this implicit intent. Okay. So for implicit intent, I will open phone diary intent. Okay. So for this one, I will go to the program. Okay. So this is your dialer demo. So what is the output of this one is, so it will, so I think this I didn't mention. And what is the example for this explicit intent is, you are switching the from one activity to another activity. So like from one activity, if I click on button, then I will go to the next activity. So this is very important program, okay? Because whenever you are creating the application, compulsory it will have multiple activities, and I have to switch from one. Once this biodata form is filled up, then I will click on login, then it has to store the data on the database, and it has to open some other new activity. So We will see these two programs. First, I will show this implicit intent. So this is our implicit intent. So for this implicit intent, I am creating this implicit intent. So it has three important things. That is, your first one is your manifest folder, activity manifest.xml file. So this is the logic for this one, and the package name is example implicit intent. And it is taking the permission of accessing the internet. We will see why I am mentioning this one, user's permission. So if you want to, whenever I am installing the app, right? So at the time of first installation, it will take some permissions. It will accept, it will ask for some permissions, right? So what is the permissions like, whether I can give the access for my mobile phone to give the permission to allow the contacts, or allow the camera to open, or allow the gallery to open, allow the media to open. All these permissions it will give at the time of installation. So those permissions I can define in the Android manifest.xml file by using this user's permission. Okay. So this is about related to application information. In the application, we are defining the icon and the label for this one application. So whatever the strings that are there, all these strings are defined in the resources values strings.xml file. If I open this strings, so this is the app name. What is the name of this app? Implicit intent. So that's why when I open this activity, so when that activity is opened in the emulator on the first screen, okay, when this activity is opened in the emulator, you can see the title over here there, right? Like implicit intent. Here you will get the title. I will show. Okay, so that implicit intent title is defined by using this string name. Okay, so that string, whatever the strings that are there, you have to define like @string app name. So what is app name over here? That is your implicit intent. Okay, all the strings are defined in the strings.xml file. Colors, so this is the coding standards. Actually, if I want whatever the strings that I have in the total application, those strings I will define in the strings.xml file. Okay, so this is about this one. This is the launcher. Okay, so if you take launcher related all those things, you will define in the mip map. So if you have this mip map, you have this IC launcher round, right? So this one, this you are using. Okay, so this is the default icon. If I want to change the icon, then go to this resource, just right click on this resources. Yeah, in the resources, go to this new and image asset. And this I have explained in the previous class. You can change your own icon. Okay, so this is your supports RTL, this is theme, app theme, and this is the information that is about the activity. So this is your activity, and what is the name of the activity? Main activity, intent filter, and this we have seen. This is about activity under, and this is activity main.xml file, which has only dialer. Okay, this is having a just relative layout. Okay, if I open the code, so most commonly we will use this relative layout. Okay, this is where most commonly use it. So this is your relative layout. All these are by default. Layout width is match parent, layout height is match parent, and the context is your main activity. And it has simple button. So button, what is the name of ID of this button? Is generally by default it will have my button one. Okay, if I open this button and go to this attributes, okay, so by default ID will be, if you don't specify anything, then it is a button 1, button 2, button 3, like that. But if you want to give your own ID, then my button. If you know about .NET, then you can give your ID, right? So the same thing for identification purpose. And this layout width, layout height, all these properties I can define using this attributes. Go to this attributes and you can place over here, or otherwise you can go to this code. Yeah, 1 minute, it's stuck. Okay, now yeah, so otherwise I can go to this code, and within this one we have layout width, layout height, array and parent. So just if you even adjust this in this manner also, automatically the code will come. So the text is dialer. So if I click on this dialer, automatically it has to open the dialer pad. because this is my activity. This is my activity which will contain only this dialer button. But from this dialer, I want to open the other activity. So what is that activity? Phone. Okay. So that is your phone dialer activity. So this is your implicit intent example. Okay. So if I go to this one, text color red, I set text size and style, I send bold, and onclick is the method. Okay. This is the another way. So I can write the onclick method dial, and I can define the dial button by using public void dial method. I will write. Okay. So these are the app compact activity, all these things, widget view. Okay. So whenever I am using this view and widgets, okay, whatever the buttons are, everything, I have to use this one. And first I created this main activity which is extending this app compact activity, and this button, I created this button. So whenever we define one button, right, so this button, for every button that you have created, it will automatically create one resources.java file. If you want to see this resources.java file, we have to go to this project. Okay, in the project, go to this app. In this one, build is there, right? Build. You go to this intermediates, not intermediate, generated. Within the generated, we have this not namespaced. All of you clearly observe. I will zoom this one. That it is working or not. So it's not there. Okay, no problem. Okay, so first open this project view. Inside that one, go to this app, and inside this build, go to this generated and not namespaced R underscore class sources and debug. Within this one, we have this R. Go to this Android X. Inside this one, we have this app compact. So here you will have this R.java file. This is the resources.java file. So whenever I place this R.layout.activity main, so you can just open this R.java file. So if I search for that activity underscore main, I think files under build folder are generated and should not be added. Okay. If I open this one, automatically for every XML, for every file, it will automatically create one ID. Okay. So if I open this my button, okay, if I want to see over here, it is not showing. Okay, so if I open this one, automatically whatever the files that are there, for everything it will automatically create one ID. Okay, all these are constants. So whatever we are seeing, for everything it will automatically create this r.java file, which acts as an interface between your .java file and your XML file. So for this one, onCreate, first it is which it will do, and the next one is your button, find view by ID, so that it will find by using this my button is the ID. So r.id.my button. So if I open this ID class in the r.java file, okay, if I open this build, in the generator we have this AP, not namespace R class sources and debug R Android X app compat r.java. So if I open this one, class R, so this is R dot. Okay, so R dot ID is the another class. So if you open this one, So this is your class boolean, class color, for every color or anything. Okay, this is your dimension. This is your class drawable. This is your class ID. So for this class ID, it is static. So that's why R dot ID. So R dot ID. So whatever the IDs that I mentioned. Okay, button, everything. For all the things, it will automatically create. Okay, so all this, so it is R dot layout dot. So in the layout, we have this activity underscore main. Okay, so this button, first I created find view by ID this button, and after that we have this dial function, right? Because I mentioned onclick equal to dial. So I am writing the function that is public void dial VOU, and I am giving the mobile number, and I am just calling this intent I equal to new intent, and that intent dot action dot dial, and with this mobile number. So automatically when I click on this dial, automatically it will call the dial this number. I if I want to start the activity, I will use this start activity. So now I will run this program. So just click on this run app so that it will be running. I will open this one. I think it's already there, implicit intent. So just click on this implicit intent. So this is your app is running. So I will click on this dialer. So you see here, it is opening the dial pad, right? So this is because this is my activity. So what is this activity? This is dialer activity. From this, this is implicit intent. Okay, you are getting this implicit intent is the name of the activity. So this activity, I created only one button. Okay, if I take the design, so it has only one button. And when I click on this button, what is happening over here? When I click on this button, it is opening this this telephone number. So this telephone number is there in the dial pad. So if I want to open this dial pad, so when I click on this button, it is opening the dial pad. So dial pad is a application of phone. If you open this phone, so phone is having this dial pad, right? This is the activity. And within the phone, we have this contacts. But contacts is the another app. So from my application, this is your implicit intent. So from my application, I want to open the activity of another application. Then that is your implicit intent. Okay. So we will see one more example on this implicit intent. Like I will open this phone dialer intent only. Say this is that is your dial pad intent. Then this is your phone dialer intent. So for this one also, I have the same thing, and I created this activity main. And in this one, what I will do is I have this edit text which will take some number, and when I click on this call, automatically it will call that particular number. Okay. So this is my application. From my application, if I click on call, it will open the phone calling intent. Okay. So for this one, what is the logic over here is I will uncreate. I will have this edit text and button. So for everything that I created, right? Whatever I mentioned in the layout file, .xml file, that for that one I have to find the view by ID, and this one you have to link by using this r.id. So I will click on this dial number because I mentioned over here, if I open this button on click, I mentioned it as dial number. So I will click on this dial number and I will create this dial number is the logic over here. For this dial number, automatically this button is there. So on click attribute. Okay, this is on click attribute only. No, nothing. So here you can have this dial number, and when I click on this button, so first it will take the number from the edit text. So whatever the number that I entered over here, that I will get by using this edit text one dot get text. I will convert into string, and after that I will call the intent. For the calling the intent, I have this intent dot action call, and I will call the intent by using set data. I will set the set data and I will start the activity. So I will execute this program. It will take some time. Within the meantime, I will just pass this one. So now you can see the install successfully finished. Okay, Gradle build also finished. Now I will open this app. Okay, so now this is your phone dialer intent. So I will just give some number. So I need 496778 75. This is my activity actually. So within this my activity, I have this edit text. Okay, I have this edit text, and I have this call button. So when I click on this call button, it is opening the phone. Okay, this is your phone internal app, that is your phone dialer app. So it is calling this phone dialer app, and it is calling to the particular number. Okay, so from my application, what is my application? From my application, this is my application. From this my application, I want to call the other application activity. So that is done by using this intent.action call. Okay, from my activity I want to start the another activity, or from my application I want to start the service of other application. From my activity I want to give some announcement to the other application. So all these things are called implicit intent. So with this I am concluding the today's class. Okay, we have one more concept, like different examples of this implicit intents. Okay, so we have different, like till now I discussed only this phone dial intent. Okay, dialing a phone number. I can even open a web page, and I can open the contacts application, or I can open the camera application intent, or I can open Google Maps. Okay, everything is possible through implicit intents. And I will show one more example on this explicit intent, in which from one activity I want to start the same activity within the same application. That is, we are switching between two activities. Okay, from one activity I want to go to another activity. That also we will see. That is, we are explicit intent. Within the same application, I want to go from one activity to another activity. That is your explicit intent. So we will see all this in the tomorrow's class. Hope you understand today's class, which is intent and types of intents. We have implicit intent and explicit intent.